Hello and welcome to the show. I am here today on a BeamNG drive, going to be playing around with some mods as I saw kind of rally raid spec vehicles. I really fancied having a go with these. So we can see here, you got the sunburst, it's raised up. We've got a kind of reinforced front bumper here on this car. These are like good fun vehicles to take doing some high speed off-roading. And I also found a map called Rally Ridge, as ever. I'll put links to mods in the description. That sounds like the perfect place to test these cars. I have also spotted a split ramp up ahead. I think that may be my first port of call here. Shall we go and see if the sunburst can survive a roll off of the split ramp? That was pretty damn perfect. Ooh, that was okay. Well, we've torn off the rear bumper. But yeah, it can survive a roll. Oh, I'm amazed that that went as smoothly as that on my first attempt. Fantastic. We are, oh, no, don't bounce off that. That might cause us trouble. Ooh, I spy a bridge. We're going to go exploring down a bridge. We are slightly dragging our bumper behind us, but that is some impressive going. It didn't even break the radiator. Of all of the radiator gets broken on just about every car immediately, but this thing, oh, there we go. Got rid of the bumper. Oh, okay, this is quite off-roading now. That is a steep drop. Okay, we're fine. We're good. Our exhaust is a little bit dangly. Yeah, I can't stop or turn. There we go. We've stopped and turned just about. Okay, well, this is a rather good test of the car's off-roading ability. It's not quite a rock-crawling path. It's not that far off it, though. Yeah, the radiators on these cars get broken so incredibly easy now that to have survived a barrel roll with it all intact is good going. Come on, car! I have turned off all of the electronic assists on this vehicle, so we've got no traction control, stability, etc. Oh, okay. Now, how are we going to get up here? We might want to kind of go... Oh, no, we might have some issues here. Okay. No, I think we're going to have to kind of try and time this. Go! There we go. Get the car moving. Oh, no. I don't know if we can quite make that turn. Come on. Come on, sunburst. I can't get it. There we go. It kind of stalls out, and I can't do anything about it. Go. It's not quite got enough power. That's disappointing. No. We're defeated. If it was just kind of a straight up bit, I think I could probably get the momentum from further back, but it's because we've got to try and then get it around a really tight corner. That's kind of what screws us over here. All right, let's have another go. Back it up down here. This is still a pretty... Oh, brakes. Panic and brake everything, because I wasn't quite sure where we were going. All right, let's give it a little bit of a run up. Here we go. Okay, run up for the sunburst. Hopefully this should do the trick. If we can keep enough momentum going, probably not a good idea to bounce off that inside corner, essentially. There we go. We've got momentum. Turn the car. We've kind of crashed it into the wall, but it's done the trick. Ha ha. That's how we do it. I'm kind of just having to floor it because this is getting really steep now. And, I think it's probably with the wheels going in the air. I'm not sure what diff the car has. That might be causing it some issues here. Oh, no. All of the wheels are on the ground, and it's just spinning everything. No, if I try and I try to let off the throttle, try to give it some traction. I've got to be careful, though, not to stall the car out again. And, no. Come on, sunburst. We can do it. You've got an exhaust under one of your tyres. It's probably not helping matters. We're kind of just sat here, and I fear if I go off the throttle any more, we run the risk of stalling it, and then we're probably not going to get as far up as this again. It is so tantalizingly close. Try and save something. Okay, right, go. Just going to stall out, I think. No, oh dear. The sunburst. Oh, no, the sunburst has got... traction briefly. Oh dear. Okay, well, now we're aiming the wrong way. It's not really the way that we want to be going, is it? Oh, come on, car. That's it. Oh, no. Okay, the hill was just too steep for the sunburst. Still, though, the car... Oh, that's asking for trouble. That's asking for another rollover. The car did survive a flip off of a split ramp and is going to get done over by a poor driving decision by me. That is not the car's fault at all. That was very much my fault. I can probably use the nose to just about pull the car clear of the trees. However, yeah, where that is stuck was so difficult to rescue the car. It's not really done it too much good in that one. Do we have... No, we're not going to have another go at climbing the hill. I suspect we'll probably just do the same, because I did have a really good run up to that that hill, and I could waste much time just sat there with the sunburst spinning its wheels. Now, we did briefly have the engine starved of oil while it was upside down, and we've lost a couple of tyres, but that doesn't seem to bother the car too much. I mean, it's a rally raid vehicle. It's got to be able to deal with some adversity. okay, careful with those. Yeah, those rear tyres are not looking... In fact, none of the wheels are looking massively healthy anymore, but it is still going. I wonder when we can lose the exhaust. The exhaust is starting to annoy me, dangling around down there. I don't particularly try and fancy climbing my way out of here either. Spotted there, they go. There's a road over here that we can... I mean, that's one way to make an entrance. We're fine. This is going to turn into how many rolls can I do and have the Rally Raid Sunburst still working? I'm pretty sure our rear left, at least, has lost all suspension. That's considerably lower than the other... Yeah, we've lost, like, the springs and the dampers are probably shot to hell on that quarter. The other three quarters, though, are still working. Car is still going. We've found some lovely, beautiful, smooth tarmac. Wonder how far... Oh, no, that was a dumb thing to do. How fast can we get our three times rolled sunburst to go on these tarmac roads? Can we get... Well, can we get it past the speed limit? Can we get it past 70 miles an hour? I would expect so. Can we get 100? Well, we hit 70, but I'm not sure quite where this road goes, so we're going to slow it down. Otherwise, we're probably going to have a monumental accident. See, good thing I slowed it down. Might have got around the first part of the corner. Second part of that corner, we certainly... Ooh, we're like a little bucking bronco going on at the moment. We're fine. We've made it. This road kind of loops back on itself. This looks like an ideal place for getting speed out of a quite heavily damaged sunburst. Oh, okay, we're going off-roading, because I'm not sure we're going to make that turn. 85 miles an hour. That's a tree we're bouncing towards. Okay, no, we're good. We've got it under control. Oi. Considering the damage to this car, this is really not driving that badly. This is really not driving... Oh, we lost the exhaust, finally. Hey, no more dangly exhaust. Okay, I thought that corner was going to the right. I really thought we were going round to the right there, but thank God there was a bridge. Otherwise, I would have gone straight on. Oh, we've found our way back onto the tarmac again. I'm liking these roads. They're kind of... Oh, no, the exhaust is getting back. Okay, we obviously didn't lose the exhaust. We just kind of shunted it clear. Oh, no. Break. There we go. Okay, we're fine. I like these roads because they're smooth enough so that you can go relatively quick. They're wide enough so you know that there's not immediate tree if you step a millimeter out of line. But they're still challenging. They're still challenging roads to try and drive quickly around. And certainly, you know, I'm only on the tarmac bit at the moment. We will go and find... I was just busy trying to see how fast the sunburst can go. Yeah, I think it's a pretty good mix on these between being, you know, challenging enough to make it interesting to drive down, but still being, you know, rallying enough with bumps and crests and blind corners, etc., to deal with. It's struck a pretty damn good balance. We are bouncing our way up uphill. I really thought this car was going to have given up by now, or I was going to have thrown it into something. More likely that, well, I guess kind of the first is it's been caused slightly by me throwing it into stuff. But still going well. Are we actually up by the start line? I think I might have inadvertently come back to the... I have. We've inadvertently come back to where we started. Okay, Rally Car. We're going to give it a fix, though, because I'm going to see how a full conditioned one will fare. Where shall we go? We're going to ignore... It's very difficult for me to ignore a split ramp. When I see a split ramp, I just want to take it and I want to do rolls. So that's very difficult for me to drive past that. It's, okay, let's go this way. I don't think we've been out this part of the map. Don't know where to go. The roads... There are quite a lot of different roads on here, so they split regularly, and at times perhaps a little bit... could get a little bit confusing. Like here. I'm going this way. I don't know if there are any of these roads dead ends or whether they all kind of loop around into one another. With the nature, certainly with the nature of most Beam maps that I've played, they're all on islands. So the roads tend to loop around into... Oh, that's not good. That's not good. We're tobogganing on our roof. Car, roll over. Thank you. No, that might have been too much. Oh, no, that's one too many. That's two too many. And another one. Good luck. No. Bork. That is as close as you could have it. I know the engine's starved of oil. It would probably kill the engine in this roll. However, that is... I don't even know if I can save this car. I'd have to pull it forward, I think, before I could save it safely. Car, come forward. There we go. Now we can probably roll it over. Ugh. That was, yeah, a bit of a close call in all of that. Now we have we're in second. Well and truly ruined the front of the, or the front left tyre. That's shot to pieces, and the back left is not exactly great. It's a tough bugger. I will give it that. It has survived a number of rolls. Pretty high speed rolls as well, this car. Okay, well that was the Sunburst Rally Raid car. Pretty entertaining vehicle to drive. We're going to end up in a wall, and pretty tough as well. This mod though does come with a bunch of other ones, so we shall go grab a different car. There is a Rally Raid version of the newest car in Beam, the Mirama or something like that. I don't know. It's a classic vehicle. Now the race version of this proved to be incredibly tough when I took it off-roading around Utah. You know, a vehicle not at all intended for off-roading, and it actually survived a hell of a lot of punishment. So the question is, will this car manage a similar amount? We found ourselves back on a tarmac road. This is not what we want. We want to be going off-roading. It can certainly shift, I will give it that. Oh, that's a big slide. Unintentionally, but a pretty pretty hefty slide. Oh, we're going to lock the wheels up a little bit through there. I didn't really want to go to the right there, because I'm pretty sure that's where we were going last time. This looks like a jump. Probably not too good. Ooh, that could be an interesting test. Can I get down there? How do I get down there? Ooh! Okay, found a way down there. I guess that's why you pay attention to where you're going. I may have done a pretty big stupid... Quick, roll the car over before the engine blows itself to bits. that's a way. We've got an interesting... Yeah, interesting bent chassis. Car's still working, though. Okay, I was going to see, can we get across a rocky river crossing? That is, you know, I guess a rally raid car probably should be able to do this sort of things. Unfortunately, we may have some trouble with our completely knackered chassis. Probably not going to help matters. I'm not sure even with this car as... I think we got it wedged. I'm not sure even as brand new this car would have the ground clearance for these rocks. It is also rear-wheel drive, which is less than ideal. I think we're going to have been defeated by the river crossing here. I don't even know if we could get across the rocks. It may well just drown the car in all of that, because that is some tough terrain. Right, what about down over there? I think all of these roads will loop their way back onto the tarmac road. Where do I get to go down that side? I was kind of tempted to just throw my car off, and then I thought that would be a silly idea, because there's very, very big chance I will just break the car. It's doing well at bounding its way up this hill. Again, considering this is rear-wheel drive, so it's probably not got the power of the Sunburst either. It's bounding its way up this hill very, very nicely. Where do I go to go down? Where on earth are we going? Ah, that looks like that. There we go. Found the path that I wanted to go on. There we go. Some more oversteer shenanigans from the car. This, I think I might prefer this one in some ways to the Sunburst. Hey, okay. The Sunburst did survive a massive, massive split ramp roll, which is always impressive. Are we just spinning one wheel? Okay, maybe we need a little bit more of a run up to that. Let's not try and snap the wheel. I think this might have... The wheels might survive a little bit more punishment, because that was a fairly... I'd say a fairly hefty hit, but I mean, we did very much just clip at quite high speed that front wheel on a bit of terrain, and the tyre is fine. Uh-oh, we're gonna probably roll. We saved it. I spun, but we didn't roll the car. We didn't fall off the edge of a, well, not really a cliff, but that would have been a bad place to get stuck. That's not a place that I can really rescue the vehicle from. If it ends up down there, yeah, we're not going to. Oh, no, don't oversteer. Caught me out again. Here we go. It is quite manageable. Often I've found with cars on beam, once if they do start sort of sliding, they can get a little bit twitchy. The supercar is a prime example of that. That was very easy to get that all crossed up and yeah, kind of twitch it about and end up in a wall. But this, even when I'm pratting around on dirt, being an absolute moron with the throttle, pretty forgiving in many ways. It's yeah, not quite what I was expecting. It does seem to have a very open rear diff, which is perhaps not helping matters too much with the heavy off-roading stuff. Ah, we can get to the river crossing from this side if we are still feeling brave enough. I suspect, though, this side might be a little easier on the approach. I think that was the turning I wanted, but I still think we're just going to beach it on the rocks and just get it broken. So let's go and chuck it about some more of these dirt paths to try and see what speed we can get the car up to. Oh, I found civilization. Well, kind of. We found a building. Oh, I found two buildings. We might crash into them both. Oh, or one of them. Okay, that was a bigger bump going into that section than I was expecting, really. Oh, don't tell me we've got it stuck. Okay, this is a small... Okay, no, we're good. I'm going to say it's a small issue. Have we got it stuck on? Yeah, I think the back... Oh, back's just about getting itself free now. Oh, that's very unhappy. That crash has not done my car much good. Now we've broken the radiator. So after all of the sunbursts kind of strength and keeping its radiator going, this one... It was a pretty heavy crash on the front of the car, to be honest. So we'll kind of let it off that. I think I might have broken some... Well, I'm pretty sure I've broken much more inside this car than just the radiator, because it's not handling particularly good. It looks like it certainly looks okay, but yeah, I think I might have bent something up in the steering. Okay, well, that was the sort of kind of a classic rally raid car. And finally, to finish, we've got a 200BX. You know, the Sunburst, well, is very much a rally car, so a rally raid version. Not exactly that unsurprising. The classic car, you can kind of imagine that being a classic rally car. This thing, though, well, a Japanese sports car, not exactly the first thing you think of when it comes to rallying. So, yeah, kind of interested to see how well this one goes. I believe it is the fastest of all of the rally raid vehicles. We'll see if we can get this one. Oh, I found a petrol station. Oh, yeah, I found a petrol station and very nearly oversteered my way into a banking. Yeah, I was curious to see how fast I can potentially get this car up to and how well it survives, you know, these kind of large jumps that the Sunburst did relatively well at. That both cars survived jumps and landings pretty well. Oh, we're going to end up in a mud hole. Oh dear. It's not been a good start. We broke the radiator and rolled the car all in one go. Let's just try again, shall we? Maybe we'll stick on the tarmac briefly. I'll see if we can maybe get 100 miles an hour in this. It feels like you're going so much faster because of the narrow confines, etc. Yeah, this one will probably get 100 miles an hour without too much in the way of problems. We could probably even do it on a dirt road if we could find a dirt road that doesn't have... Oh, we're going to lose the back end big time. That was a stupid bit of driving from me. Wow, this thing does not do reverse at all. Like, there is no... I think the gear ratio is maybe a little messed up for reverse. That just doesn't go. I hope we don't ever put this in a situation where we need reverse, because yeah, we're not really going to rescue the car very easily. This is a... Wow, really? That's broken the rate. I can say this is kind of a little bit more of a kind of challenging tarmac road with such narrow... I say with such narrow, but you've got the immediate rock edges either side of you to catch you out there. And I hit one, and that... It wasn't a particularly heavy hit either, and that broke the radiator. And, well, it rolled us, but the breaking of the radiator was the more concern to me there. At that precise moment in time, wow, we are flying along uphill at 80 miles an hour. I think there was another way down from up here, but I can't quite remember Because I think we can... Yeah, look, there's a path down there that I kind of want to get to. Aha! Maybe that's... Oh, no, wait. That doesn't look like that. No, that's definitely not the right way to go. It's just a giant jump. That's not the right way to get down there. What about... Okay, right. I think I might see where we have to possibly go. Do we loop around underneath? Again, I could just chuck my car off, but my car is not going to survive that. So... Okay, now that's just a big hole. That's not a fun place to to make a mistake and end up in. Because, yeah, you are not going to get out of there. Maybe... Aha! Right, I spot a road. Spot the road that I want. Okay, just around this... Is it right? Is it this corner? Ah, okay, right, yes. If we keep turning, we can go... Aha! We can go down here. Right, we can... Oh, bugger! Bugger! Things have gone wrong! Just when I found the road I want to go on, and we've managed to... Spin the car. Please don't roll over while doing a J-turn. I could just envision that going really badly wrong. Okay, we are back on a road. Let's not carry too much speed down here. I am slightly concerned that we're going to take one heavy knock and that will be it. That will be the radiator gone on the car. Ooh, I wanted to go play on the beach. Go play on the beach. Come on, car. Here we go. We've made the turn. Made the turn. Oh, that's just looking at all at the little bumps and the way things that could go wrong down there. Right. Beach. Let's see what speed we can get up to on here. Whoa! Okay, let's kill the radiator. That's killed the car. You remember the sunburst that survived a big barrel roll, landed relatively heavily, and was still perfectly drivable for about 10 minutes? That's just broken everything. Like, the car doesn't move, all of the steering is gone, the radiator is gone. I'm not sure the 200BX is your best bet. If you want a car for doing rally raid-esque stuff, I'm not sure that this is the car you want. I think while it is incredibly quick, it's just not really strong enough to be, you know, carrying the same sort of speeds that the Sunburst could across these off-roading terrain. As soon as you hit a bump, you run such a high risk of breaking the car. And, you know, yeah, sure, I'm doing some fairly extreme stuff with the vehicle, but the Sunburst can survive all of that okay. This, not quite so much, although it did survive that bump there, which is not too bad at going. This might survive the river crossing potentially, probably better anyway. Let's have a look. It's got a little bit more ground clearance. I don't actually know if this is... I'm assuming this is rear-wheel drive because I was spinning the car out. Yeah, this might survive the river crossing. That's broken the radiator. Power! Power through! Don't get beached! Don't get beached! Oh no! No! Car! Car! Uh-oh. Oh, of course, we're not going to be able to reverse it free! No! Well, I mean, it got across the river, and then I think actually the bodywork got caught underneath it that screwed it up on that one big rock. Yeah, I think you want a proper off-road vehicle more than... Maybe this does have some... Yeah, it does have four-wheel drive. Okay, I lied. It's just obviously got a rear heavy bias, perhaps. Oh, God. I'm not going to free it now. Because I can't reverse the damn thing, because reverse does not really seem to do much. And we're now more beached than we were. Oh, God, I've got it. I've got reverse moving the car. Right, rev the nuts off the thing, and then go, 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 go. Come on. Oh, that has got a fraction more ground. Admittedly, you know, the other car did have a bent chassis, but even with a fully functioning one, I think that still did not have the ride height to do it. No! No, 200, you are so close to being free of these rocks. We are going to overheat the engine, though. Ah, okay. Because the radiator's busted, of course, the engine's overheating massively as I'm trying to do this. Go! Ah! We are free of the rocks! Hey, very nearly caught us at the end there. However, the car is completely and utterly ruined in doing that. That's to be expected, really. Oh, God, the front wheels are bent beyond use! Well, never. Okay, there is a use. Found a use. It's to crash and roll. Well, I think that is the 200BX. Pretty much summed up. Come on, nope, I don't want to do that. We want to just flick the car across. Flick the car over. Could we have some... Oh, grab the... No, are we not going to grab the... There we go. Got the node. Come on, roll. Roll. I'm just pulling it. I can't quite pull it the right way. Uh-oh. We're going to, I think, end up in the drink. Yeah, the 200 is going to go swimming. Oh, bugger. It's not quite what I wanted to do. I wanted to roll the damn thing over. Well, the engine's not overheating anymore. It's full of water. Although, apparently, this isn't water because the car can drive along this bit. Okay, that might be a slight buggy bit of terrain in the map. Yeah, these rally raid cars are good fun. The Sunburst is certainly... I mean, let's face it, you know, the Sunburst you would kind of expect to be good at that kind of stuff. Surviving that fairly heavy landing from a sizable jump is very good going. The classic car, good fun. Rear-wheel drive shenanigans from that one. Quite a savable vehicle as well when things start going a little bit wrong. This thing, very, very quick. However, not the strongest of the lot. And if you're throwing it about some rough off-road trails... You do kind of want a strong enough vehicle. This could probably make it up the little narrow road that we got stuck on, but it's got the power and has got some half decent traction when you have it in the right gear. However, we do not have the strength in this. I think I remembered where I was. We will finish our grand finale for this video. Let's see if the 200 BX can survive the barrel. If it survives the roll and still is perfectly drivable, I will take back what I said about the car. I have a sneaking suspicion it's probably not going to survive this too well. Okay. Are we ready? I just noticed the car's got 21 on the livery. That's fantastic. Unfortunately, not the right colours. However, having 21 is still pretty good going. Right, here we go, 200. Let's see what you can do on this split ramp. Pretty perfect in terms of positioning. However, oh, the landing was a little flat. Okay, I mean, it still works. It does still drive. The radiator is gone. The Sunburst wasn't, and you can see the state of the wheels. That, again, I have done really well on those two barrel rolls. It's kind of been, you know, the right amount of rolling. It's not over rolled. Oh, God, I can't steer. Yeah, okay. I think that's taken out my other front. Yeah, we can't turn left anymore. Seeing as we're coming to a left corner, that's kind of quite... seeing as we're coming to a right-hand corner, that's kind of quite important. It's, yeah, a little bit knackered, really. Hey, we might make it to the gary or not. No, we're not making it to the garage. We're still steering full lock that way, as you can clearly see that side, but that side's not having any of it. Yeah, rally raid cars are pretty good fun. This is a great map for just kind of messing about with some off-road cars. I like that the roads aren't too ridiculously bumpy. They're bumpy enough to catch you out, but you can still carry some serious speed. Perhaps a little bit smaller island than some, but yeah, good fun place to go exploring around. And the Sunburst, I would definitely highly recommend. This thing, very quick. Got to be careful. A little mistake and you will be punished with a very heavily broken car. However, that is it for this video, guys. As ever, I'll put links to all of the mods that I've used in the description so you can download them, have a go with them yourself. But thank you very much for watching. And until next time, goodbye.